Hello, everybody. This is Rick with TaxDome. Thank you very much for joining us today for our product-focused webinar, where we cover one specific topic in detail for those who have already started using TaxDome. Today's topic is all about getting paid using your TaxDome portal. But before I get started, let's switch over here very quickly just to remind everybody that under our Resources tab and Education, you will see that we have other webinars that are out there that you could register for or simply watch the recordings that we have available. So if you're interested, feel free to jump back here and you can check those out as well. Now, of course, if you are interested in our overview webinar, we have an overview webinar that's more of a high-level overview of the entire system. So if you haven't seen that yet, by all means, please feel free to register for that as well. So let's get started here by walking through our agenda for today. We'll begin by discussing how to collect payments inside TaxDome. We'll touch on the TaxDome integrations with Stripe, CPA Charge, and QuickBooks Online. We'll walk you through how to create and send invoices. We'll show you how you can itemize your invoices and contracts. We'll go over locking a document to an invoice, something that we walked through in another webinar, but is definitely worth revisiting. We'll cover how you can automate your workflow by linking the invoices to jobs and using the auto move feature. We'll show you how to record a payment made outside of TaxDome. We'll show you how to track time either manually or with our built-in timer. And then we'll wrap it all up with a brief discussion about some new updates that are coming very soon. So let's start with collecting payments. Your clients can make payments to you from inside of TaxDome. They can pay with a credit card, debit card, or ACH, which is also known as e-check. Now, as you see here on the right, you can designate how you want to get paid, card only or ACH only or either one. And you can do this invoice by invoice if you wish. As far as payment processors go, we allow you to accept payments utilizing either Stripe or CPA Charge. If you'd like to utilize ACH to get payments, that goes through CPA Charge. If you happen to be using both services, you can easily set the default processor under your Integrations tab, as you see here in the bottom right corner. Now, a question that we are often asked is, what are the fees for all of this? Well, let me click over to this screen, which is our payment processing fee article. Here, you'll find all of your answers related to fees for each service. Now, I will note a few things here. First, TaxDome doesn't charge you anything additional for accepting payments. It's a pure pass-through from the processor, and we don't make a penny on this. Both companies, well, every processor that's out there, charges a percentage of the amount, but their structures might all be a little bit different. The only thing that's different is if you would like to use ACH. Those fees are usually a flat fee per transaction amount instead of a percentage. But again, you can review this at your leisure, but remember that every processor will charge you something, but TaxDome will not add anything to that. We want you to get paid through TaxDome, and we wouldn't dream of discouraging you from doing that. Now, back to our slides here. Let's touch on our QuickBooks Online integration, as there is some important things that we need to note here. First, invoices created and sent from inside TaxDome will sync to your QBO, but invoices created and sent from inside your QBO will not sync to TaxDome. Now, of course, the goal is to make life easier for your customers, so it is advised that you send from TaxDome so your clients don't have to go to another system to pay your invoices. But again, it's completely up to you on how you want to run and process your payments. So what data will actually sync up? First, it will match to the account name to the QBO display name. Also, it will show the QBO sync status in each account and on each invoice, like you see with the little green QB icon that you see here on the right. Stripe allows for a little bit more. They can sync up expense settings, but that would mean a small additional fee from Stripe in order to do that. That is not a TaxDome thing, that's a Stripe thing. So you will want to decide how important that feature would be for you. Now, if you're using CPA Charge, they will collect one monthly fee for all the transactions instead of for each transaction like Stripe does. Okay, now that we've covered accepting payments, let's show you how to send out an invoice. You can do this manually or through our automated functions, depending on what you prefer. Let's start with doing this manually. You would simply click on the blue plus new button in the upper left corner of your dashboard and you would select bill. Next up, you'd select the customer. Then you simply fill out the information that you would prefer, the amount, an invoice number, who on your team will get credit for this invoice, the payment method, whether an email will be sent, a description, and even your ability to set up automated reminders for your customer. Now, if you'd like to automate this process, you can create an invoice template, something you can use over and over again, then add the automation to a pipeline stage. Now, we go over pipelines and automations in another webinar, so we won't go through that today. But to show you briefly, on the right, you would click on Add Automations, then Create Invoice to have that done as an automated step when the job enters a certain stage in the pipeline. But the beauty of the automations, you can set the job to automatically move to the next stage once the invoice is paid. So nobody actually has to do any work. It'll move on its own. Additionally, you can itemize your invoices and contracts with services. Services include the rate type, either hourly or by item, and category. When you add services to your invoices, you are letting your clients know exactly what they're paying for. When adding a service to your invoice, you may adjust the rate and select the quantity, and the invoice amount will be updated automatically. And if you have set up your sync with QBO, all data related to services will also be synced. If you used QBO in the past and created services there, well, you can import them into TaxDome in just a few clicks. Now, really quickly, I wanted to show you that on occasion, you might have trouble syncing things up. Now, there's a variety of reasons for that, all of which are pretty simple and usually revolve around bad email addresses. But if you are having issues syncing, you'll receive a notification like you see on your screen. It's a notice of an error where you can quickly jump in, make the corrections, or fix the minor issue, then continue. And as always, if you do need help from our team, we will be here to assist you with the troubleshooting if you need some help. Now, I mentioned at the very beginning that you have the ability to lock a document to an invoice, meaning that your customer will see that you've uploaded a new document, but they can't view it until they pay the invoice. Your client would simply see a pending payment next to that document, like you see here on the right. They simply get the request to pay the invoice, and when they try to open the document, it pops up. And once they do it, well, the document will be unlocked for them. So, using TaxDome, you have a great way to minimize those AR collection issues that nobody really likes to deal with. Now, what will your customers have to do? Watch how easy this is going to be for them. When you send an invoice, they'll receive an email and a push notification to their app for those with the notify toggle turned on. That way, only people who are on the account that want to be notified will be. Your customer will simply head to the portal online or on their mobile device, and they'll see a new unpaid invoice in their to-do list, just like you see here on the right. A few clicks and the invoice is paid. But what if they want to prepay? Or what if they're sitting in your office or on the phone and they say, hey, I just want to pay this. Can you take my credit card number and take care of it? And the answer is absolutely. You can simply open their account or their invoice and key in the card number while you have them on the phone or while they're sitting in your office and you're all set. So we've shown you the how, but what about the why? Why should you do your billing through TaxDome? Well, as we've said in other webinars, there is a huge value in doing everything within one system. Although you might be used to jumping back and forth between different systems, your clients aren't. So it is very wise to keep everything together and make things easier on your customers, in turn, making things easier on you and your team. Don't send them to Dropbox to get documents, DocuSign to get signatures, Cognito for organizers, or to QuickBooks for bills. Do it all in one spot. But the locking documents to invoice feature that I just mentioned, well, that's a big one. Control your AR issues, stop chasing after clients to collect payments, and minimize those collection calls. Of course, not everybody uses this, but many out there love this feature. Okay, so next up, let's go through how to record payments outside of TaxDome. Now, perhaps you have somebody who likes to mail in a check. Maybe you have a credit card processor that you really love and you don't want to switch. Maybe somebody brought in a huge bag of pennies. Who knows? How does all of this get done? Well, very easily. You would, of course, start with the blue plus new button in the upper left corner of your dashboard, then select payment like you see here on the right. You select the customer that is making the payment. Then simply record that payment by entering the amount, choosing the source, and which invoice the payment will go to. Now, of course, you can send your client a notification of that payment if you wish. Of course, with all this activity, you want to know what's going on. So we provide some great on-demand revenue reports. Using the filter button you see in the upper right here, you can view information however you like. By status, things like paid or unpaid invoices. By staff member, who's bringing in the most money for you. By services, or by a time period. Get reports for whatever time frame you need. Now, speaking of time frame, I said we'd touch on time tracking today. As I mentioned, you have two options. You can create a manual time entry, such as I worked 2 hours on this job yesterday, and you want to enter this time. That's the example that you see right here. Or you can use the timer that's in the top right of your TaxDome portal. Simply click the time on, pause the timer if you need to, then save it when you're done to tie that time to a job or to an account. Then, once it's recorded, pull the time tracking reports you need in the same way as our other on-demand reports. Simply click on the filter button and pull the info you need by account, time period, by staff, even by timer tags if you've set those up previously to help you track and monitor the time being spent on different important functions. So as you can see, there's a lot of flexibility here, and it is entirely up to you how to view the information that you want. As an example, you can see here with this little video that we have that you can link time to a specific job so you can see how much time was spent on it. Simply link a time entry to a job just like you see here. Now, of course, you can also link invoices to jobs too if you wish. And as a side note, we're going to be putting in a new feature pretty soon to help you track budgeted time versus actual tracked time. And to wrap everything up, I did mention that we will have some new things coming down the pipe pretty soon. We're going to give the ability to create an invoice directly from time entries. We're going to be setting up recurring billing so you can send invoices on a schedule through jobs. but those would be separate from the jobs. It would be independent. We're also going to be enhancing the reporting and will allow you to link contracts and invoicing. So there's a lot of new enhancements that are in the works to really improve the billing portion of TaxDome. And with that, everybody, we have just wrapped up our topic for today. But once again, a final reminder that we do have other webinars on different topics on our website. So please feel free to check those out or just watch the recordings that we have available online. And with that, everybody, we're going to go ahead and wrap up our webinar for today. I'd certainly like to thank everybody who joined us for our webinar. Certainly hope you found this informative and it helped you understand the system a little bit better. And we're certainly looking forward to seeing everybody sign up for the free trial if you haven't and get that onboarding session scheduled if you haven't done that yet. Of course, if you do have any questions once we sign off, please feel free to reach out to our team. We'll be happy to answer any questions that you have. So that is all for today, folks. Thank you once again for joining us. And from all of us here at the TaxDome team, we certainly do hope you have a great day and a great week ahead. Thank you very much, everybody. Have a great rest of your day.